You're in tune to Chicago's most popular college music radio station. 89.3 is WKKC. This is Focus Talk, the thought-provoking, solution-oriented talk show daring to make a difference in our communities. We're talking on a regular basis because the answers really matter. What are we talking about? Well, we're talking about politics, religion, personal development, education, history, music, and then from time to time, we are spotlighting positive people who are doing positive things right here in the Inglewood community, throughout the Chicagoland area, as well as the entire United States. I'm your host, Dennis Snipe. Joining me as my co-host today is Miss Monique Harvey. Monique, how are you today?
I'm well, Mr. Snipe. How are you?
I am doing well. Thank you so very much for being here. Monique, our guest today is Dr. Carol Collum. Dr. Collum, how are you?
I'm wonderful. Thank you so much. How are you?
I am well. Now, did I get your last name correct?
That is correct.
Okay. Because I remember you told me, like, Collum on a steering column.
Yes.
And that's how I remember. So that worked very well.
That worked well.
Mnemonic device to remember. How are you?
I'm doing great.
Good. Now, give me some information as to who you are and what you do.
My name is Dr. Carol Collum, as you've said, and I am one in the community that just takes pride in education and training, working exclusively in the Inglewood community to help specifically our youth, and then again, returning citizens. So I just consider myself to just be a local resident like everyone else, but I want to see how I can help Inglewood thrive.
Okay, awesome. Now, we were talking just a little bit off mic about your profession in, can we say law enforcement?
Yes, we can.
Okay, all right.
So actually my professional background consists of three different sectors: law enforcement, social work, and education. So law enforcement was my first profession, and then I worked with the Illinois Department of Corrections for 10 years, starting out as a correctional officer and then going into senior corrections parole agent, where I supervised 378 men and or women coming from prison, returning home, transitioning back into society. I was responsible for supervising them in their homes once a month. And that was a, again, 10-year span working with the Illinois Department of Corrections. I then thought to help offset that pathway into the prison and started going into social work. Working as a school social worker, wanted to help individuals not even make it to prison and see if I could help with those resources, helping in whatever area to provide hope and pathways for individuals to, again, be strengthened as a unit or as a family in the community. And so doing that, started loving and having a passion for education and training, where I wanted to help people get that foundational education that they needed to really strengthen again who they were as individuals, to make sure that that they were able to roll out whatever pathway for life that they actually was called to have.
Now, Dr. Collum, was that a lifelong dream as a small child to be in law enforcement?
It was not.
No.
Okay. It initially started out as an opportunity, and even as I transitioned into social work and education and training, it did not make sense. But I saw later on in life how it was all interrelated and connected, because now I find myself still yet working with the reentry population, providing resources and services and education and training. So now I'm seeing how it all just kind of came together.
Okay.
Now, Dr. Collum, you have that experience in law enforcement, and you say, okay, I want to do training. So did that turn into you wanting to do the conceal and carry classes?
It actually did. I started, I've actually owned and operated my own security business back in the day, I will say, for 14 years. I just transitioned from owning and operating that particular business, but the education and training love that I had that developed, it actually had me doing my own training. So I've trained over 500 individuals in the city of Chicago to have their PERC card. And of course, the opportunity came for the Illinois Concealed Carry instructors. And so I went and got my certification to do that. And I am listed on the Illinois State Police website as an approved Illinois Concealed Carry firearms instructor. So yes, all of that education and training passion turned into me opening a actual training academy that's approved by the state of Illinois as well.
Now, those who completed their training, did you draft them into your security company? Like, hey, come and work for me.
Well, those individuals that were already hired to work for me, I invested my own ethics and morals and standards of security professionals in them. So if they, in fact, showed an interest and passed the onboarding process, then I went to sharpen and develop them into the individuals that I wanted to represent out in the security industry, representing my business. So yes.
So you said you did security and the whole business for 14 years. What did you do after that?
So after the security business, I went full time into consulting. Throughout, say 20, 25 years, I've been doing some consulting, but I'm full-time consulting now and have a number of clients, again, where I'm providing resources for the reentry population. But consulting is what I'm looking to do now. I'm doing that, and I absolutely love it.
Now, in between consulting, how did you have time to, because you have a ministry, so how do you have time to juggle the ministry and full-time consulting?
Well, I see it as one. I see what I'm actually doing from day to day is my actual ministry. So again, the reentry population being my primary population that I work with, but still yet youth, helping them get to the next level as well. Primarily in consulting, I'm doing business development or workforce development or professional development. And so it all interrelates. I still believe that that is yet my ministry. And so even though I may not be quote unquote preaching to my clients, but you know, I found that there's a way to preach without actually preaching. Mm-hmm. And you know, we're yet praying and having a hopeful heart and spreading love and joy. And so I believe that that still is ministry.
So with the ministry, you also have a community connections. What do I call it, a business, or do I call it just a community development type thing? So what do you do with True Believers Community Connections?
So True Believers Community Connections, we are actually resource partners with a lot of the organizations that are already doing the similar work that we're doing in the community. For example, Target Area works specifically with the reentry population. We're a resource partner with them. They have this organization, CSAC, Community Support Advisory Council, that works specifically about legislation and resources for the reentry population. And so again, connected with that. So True Believers Community Connections has me visibly in the community where I'm able to bridge the gap and provide linkage services with other organizations in the community. And that's primarily on the south side, Englewood specifically, but we've gone so far as to do some things in the federal prison. I usually go in and do mock interviews and resume writing workshops even there. I'm sitting on some other councils where, again, we're serious about deterring the recidivism rate. So it allows me to be very visible and a resource partner.
Okay. Now, how often do you have these writing workshops and all these development workshops? Is it twice a month, or do you have an ongoing schedule?
So it's organizational based. So these were my clients that I work with. For instance, Bethel New Life. As a matter of fact, tomorrow we will be ending a 15-week entrepreneurship class where we specifically had returning citizens come and learn how to start their own business. They've completed a business plan as well as a PowerPoint presentation where they're now prepared and equipped to go out and pitch their business concept and idea to anyone who may be interested in investing in their idea. And so that is one example where, as a consultant, I'll come in organizational based and provide whatever resources that they would request or the services that I provide. So again, everything kind of links together with the business development piece, with the returning citizen piece, and being a consultant in the community.
Now, Dr. Collin, let's go back just for a moment. Can you give me or explain the difference to me of a perk card and a FOID card?
Okay. So a perk card is a permanent employer's Registration Card, PERC, P-E-R-C. Okay. That is issued from the Illinois Department of Financial and Professional Regulation, which is in downtown Chicago, mm-hmm. which is a state regulating entity. That will allow individuals to actually work in the security industry. So your FOID card is a firearm owner's identification card. That is the card where you would register with the Illinois State Police that you have a firearm actually in your home, okay. or that you actually possess a firearm. And so that's issued by the Illinois State Police. So two entirely different entities, two entirely different purposes. That PERC card allows you to work in the security industry, not to carry a firearm.
I see.
That FOID card actually just registers the fact that you have one in your home.
Okay.
Now, Dr. Cullen, which card is the blue card?
That's the PERC card. The PERC is referred card. To the blue card because it is actually blue.
Gotcha. So what is all making these transitions? Because you went from law enforcement to consulting, and you're an author too, right?
I am an author. And so with doing the consulting and having that passion for education and training, I found myself taking on a lot of mentees and having this role and responsibility as a mentor. And then kind of really wanting to journal or write out that process because I felt like we were using that term mentor very lightly and loosely. And I wanted us to really consider mentoring in a different way. And so I began to write the book to help us look at mentoring relationships spiritually, folding in the ministry background that I have as well. And so I looked at mentoring as mentors, rather, as being spiritual midwives, and how if we have mentees and they're not birthing and not actually walking through their purpose, then are we really mentoring them? Are we really helping support them? And in fact, we're providing them a disservice if we as mentors are not helping them get to the next level. And so I thought to pen this book just to help us look at mentoring in a different way. And so it's an easy read called The Mentor's Manual, Guidelines to Giving and Receiving Wisdom.
Now, I'm curious, Dr. Collum, how would a person actually find their particular purpose or their destiny? How do you get to that particular point? Because it can be somewhat elusive.
It can be elusive, but at the same time, I believe it's relatively innate. And if there's someone who can help ask those probing questions and help you figure that out, I think we can together, you know, put our finger on, well, let's try this. Let's go through this exploration process. What seems to be simple? What seems to be your passion? What seems to be that thing that you wake up every morning and wish that you could do? And again, that's that whole role and responsibility of the mentor, asking those probing questions and walking them through that process of exploration. Because again, what are we really doing if they have not advanced and gone to the next level and then actually have successfully completed these dreams, goals, endeavors, aspirations? And so yeah, I think that's our duty as mentors.
So are there exercises that one can indulge in as far as finding out, or it's just OJT on job training?
You know, see, you're going into the next book. So there aren't actual exercises that I've identified. Again, when you're called to help someone birth, it's almost similar to really understanding what a midwife's role really is. And if we were to think back to the olden days, they actually used a stool. That midwife will set that pregnant mother on that stool, and she will coach her through when to push, when to breathe, you know, when to take, knew when to wipe the sweat off the brow. And so it's almost, you know, can you really teach when that is during that birthing process, even for the midwife? I don't know if it's really that exact, other than just that instinct of knowing when to do what. And so I say the same thing for the mentor. You know, is there really some activities? We probably can find something to again, put our finger on, but most of it, I believe, is innate. In that, you know, when you really understand your mentee and have a divine relationship with that mentee, I believe then you can gauge whether it's time for them to push, whether it's time for them to breathe, you know, whether it's just time to just wait and wait for that next contraction. So, you know, we can have some activities, but I believe it's really innate.
Okay. And Dr. Cullen, where are you finding your youth for these mentees and for your program?
I gotta say it's the Holy Spirit. Mm. I gotta say that because you have no idea through the course of every given day, people say, how do you do all that you do with so much spirit, with so much drive? And I say, you know, I'm in my niche. You know, I found my grace, and you know, the Holy Spirit, that's my inner strength, my inner being, and I have to give all glory and honor to God, and that's where my inner strength is. And so, no, I cannot say it's Carol, absolutely not. But when you get in that niche, when you get in your flow, I think everyone else can see that you're graced.
Okay, Dr. Colum, how can we get in contact with you?
You can either call me by phone, 773-851-6548. That is my direct cell number. And, of course, that's open for anyone to contact me directly. Or I can actually be reached via online at my website, www.truebelieverscc.com. And that is my website where people can reach me that way. Or someone can, of course, email me at cycollum@gmail.com. And that is my email address, cycollum@gmail.com.
Give me the phone number once again.
773-851-6548.
Dr. Colum, we have about 30 seconds left. Give me some closing words.
Closing words. For anyone who perhaps feels like they have a lot of talent, skills, abilities, I want to say you can master multitasking. And that I stand here, of course, as a product of that. A lot of people have said, you know, you're doing too much. You know, focus on one thing at a time. But I came to dislodge that thought. You do not have to just focus on one thing at a time. You can juggle multiple professions. You can juggle multiple endeavors and actually master them all. So I say that if you have the gift of administration, you can be great at multiple things.
Okay. Dr. Colum, it has been an absolute pleasure having you here in the studio.
Thank you. Please know
that the door here at Focus Talk is always open. You don't have to knock. Just come on through.
Thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate this.
Now, will you be willing to come back?
Absolutely. Okay. Anytime.
All right. I'm going to hold you to that.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you. You're in tune to Chicago's most popular college music radio station, 89.3 WKKC.
You're watching Focus Talk TV with your host, Dennis Knight.
Subscribe to the Focus Talk TV YouTube channel. Follow at Focus Talk TV on Instagram and Twitter, and join in on the conversation on the Focus Talk TV Facebook page. And in the meantime, remember to stay focused.